Good morning children, welcome to our math session. Now children, in our previous session we did chapter 15 calendar part 1. Today we will be doing chapter number 15 calendar part 2. I hope you have understood what is calendar and what does a calendar shows us or tells us. Okay, so let us use the calendar to answer the questions. Now children, you can see on the screen you have a calendar there. You have to read that calendar, you have to use that calendar, and you have to answer the questions which are given below. So the first question is, how many days are in January? How many days are in January? Okay, so tell me, look at the calendar and tell me how many days are there in the January. 31, correct. So there are 31 days in January. And what day of the week is January 17? Where is January 17? Here. Okay. So what day of the week it is? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So it is Thursday. So we'll write Thursday. Okay. Then what day of the week is January 29? Where is 29? Here. So what day of the week is January 29? See, what day? It is asking day, children. So you have to write, when it asks day, you have to write day. When it is mentioned date, you have to write the date. Okay? So what date of the week is January 29? Tuesday. So we will write Tuesday. Okay? Now, how many Mondays are in January? How many Mondays, children? Let us count. Now see, on top also you can see a blank column in Monday, but you don't have to count that because that is blank. Okay, you have to count only the days which are filled with numbers. So we have 1, we have 2, we have 3, and we have 4. So how many Mondays are in January? 4 Mondays. Okay, then you have how many Wednesdays are in January? Now you're going to count the Wednesdays. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many Wednesdays are there in January? 5. So how many days are in January? 31. What day of the week is January 17? Thursday. What day of the week is January 29? Tuesday. How many Mondays are in January? 4. And how many Wednesdays are in January? 5. Now next, what date? Now see children, this is a July calendar, so you have to answer the questions of July. Okay, that is July 2012. What date on the calendar is July 27? So tell me what date is. Okay, what day on the calendar is July 27? Here is July 27. So what date is coming? Friday, correct. So we'll write Friday, Friday. Okay, how many Tuesdays are there in July? What is the question? How many Tuesdays are there in July? So let us count the Tuesdays. This is Sunday, Monday, and this is Tuesday. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 5 Tuesdays in July. Independence Day is on 4th day of July. Independence Day is on 4th day. Wait children, I'll erase this so the calendar will be more clear to you. Okay, now Independence Day is on the 4th day of July. So children, we have to count the 4th day. This is the 1st day, 2nd day, 3rd day, and 4th day. 4th day is what children? It is July 4th. We have to write the date. It is asking about date, not day. So Independence Day is on 4th day of July. So we have to write the date. So what is the date on that? Our date will be 4 July 2012. Okay, 4 July 2012 will be our 4th day of July. That day you are having Independence Day. Now Independence Day, as usually we celebrate on 15 August, but here in the calendar it is mentioned in July. We will assume that Independence Day is on 4th day of July. So we'll write the date as 4th July 2012. Now fourth question. Ted's birthday is exactly 2 weeks from Independence Day. Write the date. Ted's birthday is exactly 2 weeks from the Independence Day, write the date. Now we counted Independence Day on 4th July, correct? So it is next exactly 2 weeks. So what is exactly 2 weeks? We'll see. After 4th July, 1 week will be, 4 to 11 will be 1 week, and 11 to 18 will be 2 weeks. So Ted's birthday will be on 18 July. Okay, what will be the exact 2 weeks from Independence Day? That is 18 July. Okay, now we'll move to the next one. Now here the calendar is January 2016. Okay, now we will read the questions and we'll answer. This new year is the beginning of which year? This new year is the beginning of which? So now children, what is the first question about? This new year is the beginning of which year? Now new year is on this new year. What is the beginning of which year it is starting? It is 2016. This new year is the beginning of which year? 2016. Okay, this new year is the beginning of, on the calendar what is there, we have to mention that only. Okay, not you have to write by yourself. What is the name of this month? What is the name of this month? What is the name of this month, children? January. Yes, wait, I'll correct this first. 2016. Okay, what is the name of this month? January. I'm not having place, children, but you write full. Okay, I'm trying to adjust. Okay, I'll delete this. Now when is Martin Luther King's birthday celebrated? See, you can see in the red pink color, see it is marked here, Martin Luther's birthday. Now when it is celebrated, Martin Luther King's Day celebrated, it is celebrated on Monday 18 January. So what you are going to write is, wait one second, I'll erase this so that I can get the place to write. Okay, so when is Martin Luther King's Day celebrated? It is celebrated on 18 January. So we are going to write here 18 January. Now children, I'm not having place, so I'm writing Jan, but you will write full January spelling. Okay, how many weekend days are in this month? Now children, weekend means what? Weekend means Saturdays and Sunday are called weekend, and Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Fridays are known as weekdays. Okay, so how many weekend days are in this month? So in Saturday first we'll see how many days. 1 2 3 4 5. And in Sunday, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 and 5, 10. So how many days, how many weekend days are in this month? 10 days. Okay. Then, I have to move again and again this. On which date does the Saturday, last Saturday fall? On which date it is, okay? On which date does the last Saturday fall? Now children, what is the last Saturday? Wait, I'll erase. What is the last Saturday? See, when it is the last Saturday? See, this is the first Saturday, second Saturday, third Saturday, fourth Saturday, and this is the last Saturday. So on which date does the last Saturday falls? It is on 30 Jan. Understood children? This new year is the beginning of which year? January 2016. What is the name of this month? The name of this month is January. When is Martin Luther King's Day celebrated? It is celebrated on 18 January. How many weekend days are in this month? There are 10 day weekend days in this month. On which days date does the last Saturday fall? It falls on 30th Jan. Okay, clear with this? Now next. Now children, this is March 2020 calendar. and we will read the questions and we will answer the questions below. How many days are in March? How many days are in March? See the calendar, children, and tell me how many days. Last date is 31. So how many days? 31. There are 31 days in March. Then what day of the week is March 20? See, where is March 20? Here. So what day it is? It is not asking date. It is asking day. So what day of the week is March 20? Is Friday. Yes. So we will write Friday. What day of the week is March 18? Where is March 18? Here. And it is asking what day of the week is March 18? It is Wednesday. Okay. I'm not having place, children. You write days. Okay. How many Mondays are in March? How many Mondays, children? Let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many Mondays are in March? 5 Mondays. Okay. How many Fridays are in March? Let us count the Fridays. 1, 2, 3, 4. Down below it is empty column. No date is written. So you will not count that Friday. So you have 1, 2, 3, and 4 Fridays in March. Understood, children? How many days are in March? 31 days. Okay? You are going to write the answer, children, properly. That is with days. 31 days. Only 31 will not get marks, right? 31 days. Okay? What day of the week is March 20? Friday. What day of the week is March 18? Wednesday. How many Mondays are in March? 5. How many Fridays are in March? 4 Fridays. Okay? Next. So, with this, children, we finish our today's session of calendar part 2. Now, I'll tell you what you're going to do, children. See, you're going to write in your notebook chapter number 15 calendar. Don't write part 1, part 2. Okay? The previous notes which I have taught you, I'll give you in the live session. So don't write the part 1 notes that I'll give you in the live session, okay? Now what you're going to do is, you're going to read the question and just see the calendar, children. Nothing answer is written here. You're just going to see the calendar and then you're going to read the question and write the answer in your notebook. Write the question and no need to draw a calendar. From the slide, you can see the calendar and you can write it by yourself. Just see the calendar, read the calendar or use the calendar and answer the questions which are given below. You will write question number 1, that is how many days are in January. Then you will see there are how many days. Then you will put a dash how I have put here. Then you will write your answer. Okay. Then in the second question, you will write what day of the week is January 17. Answer you will find by yourself and then you will write and then you can match it with the slide where I have given the answer. First, just write this. Okay. Then you will come to the second on a fresh page. One calendar on one page. Then on the second page, don't draw the calendar, children. Questions are in front of you. Just write the question and below that write the answer. Search the answer and write. Okay. Then you will write the third one. Like that. Then fourth one. So one page, one calendar. So you will not draw four calendars. Only it will be written your question answer. See in the calendar and answer the question accordingly. Okay. Whatever, don't make the calendar, okay? It will take lot of time. So you can just look at the calendar, you can read the question and you can write it. If any doubt you have, children, understanding this concept, you can write it in a book, the questions which you are not understanding, the topic which you are not understanding, and you can ask me during the live sessions. This I am going to repeat all the topics again in the live session, so don't worry if anything is not understood by you. Just make a note of it. I'll definitely solve all your doubts during the live session. Okay, children? So till then, keep learning and keep practicing. See you soon in the next session. Bye. Take care.